Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Please bear with me, I'm trying to reconfigure my living room, so my background is going to keep changing a little bit in some of the videos. Not having the best week, I've hurt my wrist. It's not too serious, but it is a bit painful right now. So today I'm going to be swatching some of my current favorite lipsticks. I've got a mix of some everyday wear soft shades and then I've got some deeper colors. Now some of these brands are new to me, so I'm really excited to share these with you. Let's start with some of the softer colors. So I've got the shade Browning Glory by Sugar, and this is probably my favorite nude lipstick. It's a peachy brown. I've got backups of this. This is how much I love this. So it's got a bit of peach, it's got a little bit of brown in it, and I think it's got a tiny bit of pink as well. It's just such a flattering color. Also, it's completely opaque, full coverage, stays well but not like drying matte. It's a nice creamy smooth matte color, and I love using this as a blush as well. You can try using it as a cream blush. It's a very flattering color. So that is my first pick. I would also recommend this for wheatish and deep skin. It's going to look a little more nude on darker skin, and on lighter skin it's going to look a bit more brown, but on my medium skin it actually looks like just the perfect nude but not washed out color. Next, I have a lipstick from the brand Just Herbs. This is the first time I'm trying one of their lipsticks, and this is in the shade Dolly. This is a deep rosy brown color. I was expecting this to be a bit more peach, I think, but it's definitely quite pink and mauve on me. It's a beautiful color, especially for wheatish and deeper skin. If you're looking for an everyday wear pink that's not too loud, that's not too nude, this has a really nice brownish tinge to it, which I find is very flattering for Indian skin. So definitely recommend this if you've got wheatish skin or deeper skin and you're looking for an everyday pink. Now the next shade I have here is from a brand called Disguise Cosmetics. This is an Indian brand. I've tried some of their products before. This is their lipstick in the shade 04. I don't know if it has another name, but this is another really nice color that you can wear day to day. Also love the packaging. It's a magnetic packaging, and I always find that really like good quality when you have that satisfying click of a magnetic cap. This applies really smoothly. You can see the color payoff is really nice. This is more of a peachy color. There's a bit of brown as well. I guess I could say it's more of a terracotta color, but it's super flattering. I would recommend this for people with medium to wheatish skin tone. On lighter skin, I think the brown is going to be more dominant, and on darker skin, I think it might not look as neutral. It might look like a little bit of a peachy bright color, but I think for medium and wheatish skin, this is going to be just the perfect peachy brown. Now the next shade is from L'Oreal. They've added some new colors to their Rouge Signature Liquid Lipstick. This one is called I Insist, and it is this berry color, I would say, with a little bit of brown in it. This is such a beautiful color, as you know, we transition into autumn and winter, and I've been wearing this a lot lately. I also really like this formula. It almost feels like a stain. It's very light, it's not super thick and heavy like a lot of liquid lipsticks. So it almost feels like a stain. I know it looks a little glossy on camera right now, but in a few minutes it's going to settle down and become matte, but not really exactly like a very dry matte. It stays like a soft matte. These stay really well because these are like stains. They actually don't get transferred and removed very easily. So once you've got something like this, especially a color which is a bit deeper, it actually stays really well. This is actually really nice as a blush as well. I felt like my cheeks were looking just very pale. So I just added a little bit of this. It looks really nice. So you can see the color has already settled down. Doesn't have that shine anymore. Highly recommend these. I think especially the newer shades are really nice. Again, this one is called I Insist. I would definitely recommend this too. I think this is a color that would just work for all skin tones, but especially for medium and deep skin, I think this is going to be super flattering. And then the last color I have here is the one I had used in my previous video, the Date Night Look at Home, and it is MAC Fashion Legacy. This is just the most intense bright red I have, and I don't wear a lot of reds anymore, but I don't know what it is about this color that I just feel just so powerful when I put it on, so I've been wearing this a lot lately. I will say this about the MAC liquid lipsticks. They are very opaque and pigmented. So this is like a single stroke lipstick. You get that intense color in just one swipe. The only downside is that they get a bit dry over time because they're so long lasting. Just like any other long stay lipstick, they tend to make your lips dry. I would say maybe like 2-3 hours in. And they also sort of dry quite instantly. So I would suggest if you have really dry lips or lips which have lines like mine, it's better if you use like a lip primer or a nice balm before using this because they can emphasize the lip lines a little bit. So that was my last pick, the lipsticks I have been loving. If you have tried any of these, I would love to know in the comment section below. Let me know your current favorites as well. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you soon in my next video. Bye.